Senator Tolentino, congratulations to you on this. You are the principal sponsor of the proposed archipelagic sea lanes law. It went on third and final reading with a vote of 22-0. Explain to the public, what difference will this make if it becomes law for the Filipino people? Anong magbabago sa West Philippine Sea kapag batas na po ito?
Sorry to simplify this. So for the first time, I think this is 18 years in the making. For the first time, you will have a law that will be designating 3 nautical highways within our archipelagic waters. And this will have to be submitted to the International Maritime Organization for their concurrence, because it has to be announced globally to all maritime countries, members of the IMO. That's pursuant likewise to the United Nations Law of the Sea Convention. And this is not just your normal sea routes. It will also include overflights, meaning to say aircrafts, foreign aircrafts, can now pass above that sea lanes. So this is likewise pursuant to another international convention, the Chicago Convention. It is now dual in application, a sea route, a sea lane, as well as an aircraft lane. And it will now allow our law enforcement agencies, and this will now include the Philippine Navy, to monitor where these foreign vessels would pass. So we just designated 3 sea lanes to enable foreign commerce and even foreign warships to traverse. Because right now, kahit saan sila dumaan, hindi natin sila namumonitor. Kaya minsan, you'll notice...
Will they respect domestic law, Senator Tolentino? That's actually, it's surprising that considering we're an archipelago, that this law has not existed before.
Yes, they should. Existing maritime conventions, specifically most of all the maritime countries are members of this convention, the IMO, they should respect. And the Philippines, with the passage of this law, can now prohibit certain vessels to ply the route when certain conditions apply. For instance, if it is determined that it would be prejudicial to national security, if it would endanger the environment, if it involves a non-approved war exercise, you cannot do that. So a lot of things can now be done, and we specified the three routes. This is the Philippine Sea Balintang Channel, sa taas po yon, before Batanes, east and west, and then we have the Celebes Sea, Cebu to Pasig going to Mindoro, straight out to the West Philippine Sea. And the third one would be Celebes Sea, Basilan, straight to Sulusi, and Balabac, straight out to the West Philippine Sea. This is crucial because if you will notice, during the height of before Typhoon Karina, reports came out that a Chinese vessel was seen near Manila Bay.
Yes.
Reports came out that a Chinese vessel was seen loitering near the Lubang Island in Mindoro. So the Archipelagic Sea Lanes Law would mandate that all vessels traversing these 3 sea lanes should do so in a continuous, expeditious, non-stop manner. You cannot stop. Dire-diretso ka lang. Dire-diretso ka lang. You're allowed to do that. That's part of the law of the sea. That's the Archipelagic Sea Lane Passage concept. Dire-diretso ka lang. So, and you do so if you're a warship in a normal mode. So what's a normal mode? If you're a submarine, nakasubmerge ka. So if you're outside the archipelagic sea lane, kailangan mag-surface ka. Kailangan ipakita mo yung flag mo kung anong bansa ka, kung dumaan ka submarino. And you're not supposed to pass the, what you call this, internal waters, yung loob, yung mga base. Doon ka lang sa archipelagic sea lane. So with this, we will be able to focus the limited resources of the government, especially the Philippine Coast Guard, to really put in place a system wherein we can monitor these vessels. At doon na rin yung kaap, nandun lang sa taas yung ruta ng mga eroplano. Airplanes, planes, foreign planes should not fly above the land mass of the Philippines. Hindi ka pwede maglilipad sa ibabaw ng Cebu, ng Bohol, etc., etc. Ando ka lang sa archipelagic sea lanes. That's how this law will be felt, and that's how the impact of this law would really produce more predictability insofar as our sea lanes and air routes are concerned.
Okay, now will this law prevent, for example, China building another massive infrastructure within our exclusive economic zone? For example, what we've seen through the years, Subi Reef, Mischief Reef.
Yes, yes.
Will this law protect the Philippines from China once again taking over one of our maritime features and making it into an island?
That's a different item, because from the title itself, you're referring just to the archipelagic waters. So okay. Archipelagic waters, Karen, would mean from the baselines of the Philippines.
Yeah.
I have a map here
from the
baselines. Uh-oh. This is a small map.
Yeah.
It's going landward. It's going landward.
Pero so paano yun? Yung landward, are you counting 200 nautical miles going in?
Iba yung from the baselines. From the baselines of the Philippines.
From the shore.
From our territorial sea going out. Territorial sea is 12 nautical miles from the baseline. So it's going landward. Okay. So yung loob, doon dadaan yung mga barko. Because nagtataka sila, bakit meron pang ganyan? This is what one of the concessions that we got a concession during the UNCLOS conference. That's what 1, 2, and 3. Sabi ng mga ibang bansa, okay, we will now recognize your archipelagic theory. That was during the time Senator Arturo Tolentino. But one of the downside is that allow the international vessels to pass through your archipelagic waters. So ito yung napalaki natin yung karagatan natin, pero hahayaan padaanin sa loob. But it doesn't include the prevention of that's hypothetical question you had the prevention of the establishment of islands within our EEC. So archipelagic sea lanes is from one EEC to another EEC. Entry point to an exit point na lalabas lang sila, dataan sila. And this is really part of the accepted international customary norm of facilitating trade and commerce, etc., etc.
Okay, now just very quickly on a different issue, well, connected to a bit, the bilateral consultation mechanism, right, between the Philippines and China. What do you hope to come out of it? The Philippine Navy says there are less Chinese vessels right now in our exclusive economic zone. And the DFA has said that there is a bilateral consultation mechanism ongoing with China. What do you want to come off this?
You know, this BCM has been going on for 9 years. I think this is the 9th year. If it produces a good result, so be it. If resupply missions are facilitated, so be it. But again, my tenet here is that the law of the sea convention is not just between the Philippines and China. The law of the sea convention involves all countries. And how many countries signed the law of the sea initiative? 159 or what? So it's not just between two countries. So there has got to be transparency here. Although I was briefed by the Department of Foreign Affairs, there's got to be transparency insofar as other countries are concerned. Yeah. They have to be informed what happened, what will happen, how did it happen, how can we be of assistance? Because a lot of countries are also involved, not just in trade and commerce issues, but even in engaging us in defense and other exercises that would really shore up our again defense posture, yeah. National security.
I like what you said, that there should be transparency with the results of the bilateral consultation, yes, mechanism, because we've seen it in the last few months wherein there were accusations, allegations that former President Duterte agreed to this, right? And then it turns out he didn't agree, did agree. There was a gentleman's agreement. And at the end of the day, when two countries are involved, and as you said, more countries, there should be transparency in what transpires.
Not just, Karen, insofar as other countries are concerned, but transparency to inform the Filipino people. Yes. Ano ba yung pinag-usapan nyo dyan? Bakit kayo nakapag-deliver? Ano, okay na ba yung ganyan? Because it involves not just the present situation there in Ayungin Shoal or even, God forbid, sa Bajo de Masinloc, kung ano man mangyari. Pero ang sinasabi ko, dapat alam din ng taong bayan kung ano yung nangyayari kasi nakataya po lahat dyan.
Okay. All right. Now, there's been a new development, and I want you to watch this. And it's tied to, in the way, the West Philippine Sea, your stand, and also, I think, your political future. I want you to watch. This is a soundbite from former President Duterte, which apparently is a development coming from your resignation. Can we play that?
It could be illegal in the sense that it would involve the security of the person.
Security. Okay.
Yung kay Inday, what is deplorable there is that it was taken na hindi alam. And for security, hindi naman siya, walang kalaban yan. Oh, whenever she goes, she does not need the 75.
All right. Okay, I apologize for that. Senator Tolentino, actually, that's a very long interview of former President Duterte, and they actually cued a different soundbite, but I'm hoping that they'll find the soundbite, but it's this soundbite. This is what former President Duterte said. I'll read it verbatim. Senator Tolentino is, nag-usap kami, sabi niya, aalis kami, iiwan ko kayo, maglipat na ako. So kung tatanungin mo ako ngayon kung susuporta ako sa kanya o hindi, iniwan niya kami, di iiwan ko rin siya. If I go out to a full campaign slate, I don't think it will look nice to the PDP party na umalis siya sa amin. Ibig sabihin, hindi ako bilib sa inyo Tapos susuportahan kita. Wala na. Ako naman, sa laro na ito, iniwan mo ako, bakit kita susuportahan? So I'm reading it. It's the exact soundbite, but it's in the news. So I want to ask you first, why did you, ba't ka nagpaalam kay former President Duterte? I think it's quite well known that he supported you during your Senate run, and you're very good friends. What happened?
I think my letter was out there, and it's self-explanatory. You've read the letter on the basis of some issues concerning foreign policy, especially multilateralism and the bilateral approach. So I think it's self-explanatory. Respect the views of a former president, a good friend of mine. So I would not comment further on that, Karen.
All right. Okay, so I respect that. And moving forward, what party will you be running in?
Right now...
Are you even running? Aren't you till 2028, sir? Or
yes, 2025. Right now, I have positioned myself as an independent.
Okay.
As an independent, I position myself to be on the side of the people. Mm-hmm. If there are things that that need exposure or that would need transparency, like what happened yesterday in terms of that marina incident involving that vessel. So I came out and declared that probably the government might be at fault, and if they do good, I praise them. So I'll side with the people.
All right. Well, on that note, is there anything you would like to add, Senator Tolentino?
I just probably would like to thank your program again for allowing me to guest. But the two vital pieces of legislation which the Senate, the Congress just passed are really historical. The Maritime Zones Law and the Archipelagic Sea Lanes Law. We hope that this would really fortify our sovereignty as a nation, as a people, and really rally support, not just from the members of the international community, but our own people. Ito po yung batas na kailangan natin para pagtibayin po yung ating kasarinlan.
On that note, Senate Majority Leader Francis Tolentino, thank you for joining me today, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.